Circles are small, keep a certain few, only ever us, just the perfect crew. People ask for
what's up, dudes?
So today I have a special video. Well, it's not really special, but we're continuing all of the comments that came in into the What If Yugoslavia Reunited Today comments about Tito and everything else. I found this video from Tito, like, I don't know how many years ago this is. The quality is shit, so bear with me, please. And I'm gonna translate to you what he's saying and how far ahead this guy, well, he already knew all the problems that the country would have. He was the controller. Let's say that he controlled all the puppets and kept them playing so they didn't tangle up and destroy each other, which eventually happened. But now I'm going to show you the video where he explains how this puppet game works and how it's working right now. He already knew that if the puppets would play like this, this game would be shown. Eh? I put everything in a puppet's perspective because I like the Muppet Show. I'm gonna walk you guys through this. 3, 2, 1, go.
Это другови и другарице. Я овде у Херцеговини, гледајући сада и знајући опће шта се код нас догађа све. Ja vas upozoravam i molim, budite budni i pazite, ne dozvolite neprijatelju da on rovari između nas.
Okay, he's saying, okay, I know you guys, I'm here today in Herzegovina, in Bosnia Herzegovina, and I'm recognizing the diversity here. Do not allow enemies to dig between us and create tension between us.
Najveća vaša, kako da kažem, vaš dobitak u ratu je bio da se spreči ovde dalje širenje unutrašnjih međunacionalnih sukoba.
So, what he's saying is the best thing that happened to Bosnia is that you guys are the ones who held up all the war between all the countries, because Croatia, Serbia, Montenegro, Macedonia, all those countries were from different sides fighting with each other, etc. But in the end, it all ended in Bosnia. So there is a part of the Croatian guys, a part of the Serbian guys, part of the Ottomans or the Muslims, etc. The Bosnians, however you want to call them. And that's why what he's saying, like, Bosnia is this neutral ground where all the surrounding countries are holed up or created their buffer zone, no man's land.
Ne dozvolite da se to ponovi. Ja sam odmah posle rata išao iz Splita preko Širokog brega. Meni su zaustavili u Širokom bregu, stali su preko puta ovako rukama. Stani druže Tito, mi nismo više ono što smo bili. Dakle, ljudi su nekako osjetili da su u prošlosti bili na pogrešnom putu i da treba iti novim putem.
He says he was on his way from one town to another in Bosnia, and people ran out onto the road and said, hold up, comrade Tito. And they said, well, drug is like friend Tito, or I don't know how you want to call it exactly. But, and the people said, like, we were following a path that's not the same as we would want to follow, and it's giving us a different feeling. And he says, like, the people knew that the path they were going through, the path they were following, was not the right path, so they had to change their path.
Ne dozvolite da se vraćaju na taj stari put. Imate ovde nacionalnosti, Srbi, Muslimani, Hrvati i tako dalje. Ne dozvolite da vam dolaze izvana, ne iz inostranstva. To je sporna stvar, to mi lako sprečimo. Nego iz naših krajeva, drugih krajeva.
So the audio is really bad, but in the first part he's saying we have Serbians, we have Bosnians, we have Croatians, well, Muslims, etc., all living together in this country. Do not allow any foreign party to intervene in your country and your relations. And that's exactly what happened during the war. We had NATO, we had Russians, we had all kinds of fucking external countries just swarming our freaking land. He's also saying don't let, he says external parties, so it's not even NATO Russians, but he's also saying is from Belgrade or from Zagreb, don't let those other countries intervene in Bosnia. And what's happening? All those politicians and political sides and territories are have really strong connections to their home country. So the Herzegovinan side has a strong connection to Croatia and Zagreb. Republika Srpska has a strong connection to Belgrade, politically seen. It's just exactly what this guy is telling them. It's like, don't let this happen. And what's happening? Exactly that is happening.
Da razbijaju to vaše jedinstvo koje je naše postalo mnogo krvi, potoče krvi koje nas ljudi proju za to braće jedinstvo. Vi se sjećate vrlo dobro da na naše zastavlje zapisano braće jedinstvo.
He's saying like, don't let them destroy our unity. You all know that we are strong because of our brotherhood and unity, and don't let them destroy that. Let that be the first thing on your list. It's just so painful to watch this. And people tell me like, why are you looking at those history films? It's history, like, to move on. But we do not have to forget history, because history is teaching us lessons. And it's funny that people who are not really interested in history feel at the same places. Napoleon, he started a two-front war, lost. Germany started a two-front war, lost. He could have, like, Hitler could have learned from that kind of things, like those kind of things. You divided, we were at war, we got united, and again, we are at war, and we again are now separated. So, history is just repeating itself, and people are not realizing that because they don't want to give it attention or learn from history. From like people like this and speeches like this from really old videos, I'm learning like a shit ton of stuff. I'm learning to interpret the way we're living now in a different way just because of this thing, these videos.
Smo došli sa prijateljskim brigadama u Bosnu sa parolama braće jedinstvo. Mi smo došli tada kad smo na dnu Drine vidjeli trupla, leševe,
He says, we're coming from a time where we saw dead Muslims, where we saw dead people on the riverbanks. And now in this country, they're parading together with banners of brotherhood and unity. And this is the guy who made that, who just did that. And people are saying now, no, we can't. We had too many dead people and stuff. I understand, but this guy did it already once. And if someone already did this, why couldn't it happen again? Why not? I think that it is possible, but for it to happen, someone like him, someone with this mindset, needs to get a big following and get power. In the rest of the video, it's just a repeating of the same thing, but with a bit better audio quality, etc. But the video quality is shit. But I hope you guys, with my translation, you get the point on what this guy was saying already back then. And this is exactly what I've been preaching in my videos. That what the problem exactly is in Bosnia. Why everything went to shit. What is needed to fix it. And how someone like this kept everything together for so many years. He might have done it not in the best way, but he made it possible. You can say whatever you want, but playing such a dangerous game with so many groups that have like only this layer of history behind them of war, death and chaos, and making them, what he said, walk together with banners of brotherhood and unity. That's just insane. Like, so much respect for this guy, so much respect for his knowledge of politics, international politics, of running a country, infrastructures, diversity in groups, ethnic diversions, and religious, and controlling all those groups separately and just balancing them. Ah, man, you can say whatever you want. You can comment whatever you want on those other videos, but this guy knew what was going to happen already back then and was trying to control that and trying to teach people that, preach them. And in the end, they didn't listen. And look at what point we are now. Like on the edge of turning to shit. Like we already turned to shit. But we're on the edge of becoming nothing. Absolutely nothing. Like air. Like gone. Hope you guys like this video about Tito's preach. This link to the other videos on Yugoslavia and on Tito and on Bosnia, etc. If you do, leave a like down below. Subscribe to my channel if you want to see more of these upcoming videos. And don't forget to click on the notification bell, because otherwise you won't be notified when I upload a new video. So I thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Ciao!